Hello my dear students, welcome back to chemistry class beta. So in today's class I'm going to discuss about the physical properties of aldehydes and ketones. So what are the various types of physical properties exhibited by the aldehydes and ketones? In that, number one is physical state. So first of all, I want to give the information about the physical states of aldehydes. Okay, so in that aldehyde, may first aldehyde, primary aldehyde, what is the formula beta? So that is nothing but the formaldehyde. Formaldehyde formula is nothing but HCHO. So formaldehyde is a gas. And what about other aldehydes? So other aldehydes, and also I want to say that next to 10 members of aldehydes, next 10 members of aldehydes, that means after formaldehyde, acetaldehyde is there. Mean from acetaldehyde to up to 11 carbon nana. So simply we can say that up to 11 carbon. So formaldehyde is a gas and other aldehydes up to 11 carbon, all they are nothing but the colorless volatile liquids. Okay beta, right. नेक्स्ट फिजिकल स्टेट इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट द कीटोन्स के बारे में डिस्कस किए समझो. सो आई वॉन्ट टू से दैट कीटोन्स अप टू अगेन सेम थिंग बट 11 कार्बन्स, दे आर ऑल्सो इन सेम फिजिकल स्टेट, दे आर ऑल्सो नथिंग बट कलरलेस वोलेटाइल लिक्विड्स. So aldehydes up to the 11 carbons and ketones up to the 11 carbons, all they are what beta? Colorless volatile liquids. And only formaldehyde is nothing but a gas. So which type of gas beta? It is nothing but the compound. So pungent smelling gas. So pungent smelling gas is, answer is nothing but formaldehyde. And remaining aldehydes up to the 11 carbons, okay, all they are colorless volatile liquids. And up to the 12 carbon ketones, they are also nothing but colorless volatile liquids. Next point, okay, up to the 11 carbon aldehydes and ketones, both are colorless volatile liquids. What about higher member? So here I want to say that all higher member of aldehydes and ketones, all higher member of aldehydes and ketones, more than 12 carbon beta, so we have to say that all they are nothing but what beta? Solids. Ye tumhara information about what beta? Physical state. Next physical property I want to discuss about the order beta, nothing but smell ke bare mein apan discuss karenge about the order information. Yes. So about the order, first of all, again I want to say about the formaldehyde. So what is the formula of formaldehyde beta? HCHO, and also we can say that CH2O. Yes, it is the formula of what beta? Formaldehyde. So already I have told you that formaldehyde, it contains the smell is nothing but, it is a pungent smelling gas. Try to be remember beta, important. So pungent smelling gas. Okay, formaldehyde, it is in order is nothing but pungent odor, nothing but unpleasant smell. Next, what about other aldehydes? So in that other aldehydes also, especially I want to say about the lower aldehydes. So what about formaldehyde? Formaldehyde is also sub say lower aldehyde. Okay, now after that, acetaldehyde, propanaldehyde, butanaldehyde, like that beta. So all they are also nothing but lower aldehydes. Okay, lower aldehydes, all the lower aldehydes, they are having pungent odor, that means they are having unpleasant smell, means not easy to accept nana. Okay, all of you. So okay, somewhat ganda smell nana, bad smell. So lower aldehydes, they are having unpleasant and very sharp pungent odor. An example is something like formaldehyde, it is very dangerous and highly pungent. Okay, now smelling gas. Okay, next one is nothing but here I want to say one more point. So this point was very 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 important to you now. Aldehydes, if they are having lower carbon, they are more pungent, means more okay now foul nature, smell nature meta, I mean unpleasant odor. If they are having higher number of carbons, if they are having more number of carbons, as the carbon nature goes to be increases, their pungent nature goes to be decreased and their fragrance nature will be increased. Once again, I am going to say that. So lower member of aldehydes, they are having bad smell, pungent odor. But higher member of aldehydes, they are having good smell, that is nothing but fragrance smell, nothing but perfume smell. So yahan par kya hua, difference is what? So lower aldehydes pungent odor, higher aldehydes are nothing but what, fragrance odor. The meaning is nothing but as the number of carbons increases, their fragrance nature, their perfumery nature will be increased and their pungent nature goes to be decreases. That point was very important. So here I am going to say that as the number of carbons increases, maybe aldehyde or maybe ketone, whatever that may be, as the number of carbons increases, their pungent nature goes to be decreased. Pungent nature decrease ho jata beta, but their fragrance nature will be increases. So pungent nature goes to be decreases and fragrant nature that goes to be increased. So as the number of carbons increases, their perfumery nature, their fragrance nature will be increased and their pungent nature goes to be decreases. That's why I have told the statement clearly. Lower aldehydes, they are having higher pungent odor, bad smell. But as the number of carbons increases, they becomes higher odor, pungent nature goes to be decreases and they will becomes more what, Nana? Fragrance, and they will becomes more perfumer. That's why higher member of aldehydes and lower member of aldehydes, which type of aldehydes are used in making perfumes? That is nothing but, the answer is nothing but higher member of aldehydes. So try to remember. So higher member of what, beta? Aldehydes and ketones. Higher member of aldehydes and ketones, they goes to be used in making perfumes and also they can be used in making flowering agents. Flowering agents. This is the important point, Mama. Okay. So lower member of aldehydes, due to their pungent odor, due to their very bad unpleasant smell, they cannot be used in making perfumes and flowering agents. But higher member of aldehydes and ketones, they can be used in making perfumes and flowering agents, because this is the rule, Mama. The rule is, as the number of carbons increases, their pungent nature goes to be decreases and their fragrance nature will become high, Mama. Okay, all of you, this point try to be remember beta. And one more thing I want to say, that especially that is about the acetone. What is the formula of acetone? CH3 bonded to C double bond O, again bonded to CH3. It is a very special liquid. Its nature is nothing but inflammable nature. So we have to say that it is a highly inflammable liquid. Nothing but it goes to be easily sets on fire. Okay, fire ke upar jaldi set ho jata, then it gives more brightful what, na, flame. So it is a highly inflammable liquid. What is the compound, beta? Acetone. You know this formula very well, beta. So this is the information about the iske bare mein, beta, odor. Once again, formaldehyde is a pungent smell, okay, smelling gas. And lower aldehydes, all they are having unpleasant smell and pungent smell. But higher members, they can be used in perfumes and flowering agents, because of reason, as the number of carbons increases, unka pungent nature kam ho jata, perfume nature badh jata, beta. Okay na? And acetone is a highly inflammable liquid. It going to be easily sets on fire. Yes, beta. Two physical properties we have finished now. Next, another physical property I am going to be said, that the information about the solubility. Solubility ka information discuss karenge now. So in that solubility, first of all I want to say that lower member of aldehydes and ketones and higher member of aldehydes and ketones. So let me consider, first of all aldehydes and ketones, they can be soluble in organic solvents. Okay, beta, this is the primary point. All types of aldehydes and ketones, they goes to be highly soluble in, and also we can say that fairly soluble in organic solvents. So which type of organic solvents we can consider? So many examples we can consider. Let me write one example, is nothing but benzene. Another example I am going to be write, that you suppose ether, and also you can write petroleum ether. No problem, beta. Next one is I'm going to take that chloroform CHCl3, and also we can take carbon tetrachloride, benzene, petroleum ether, like kerosene, like that number of organic solvents we can consider. So most of the all aldehydes and ketones, they goes to be fairly soluble in organic solvents. So many examples we can consider it. Next, this point is very important to you. It's a common point. One more point is, especially here I'm going to discuss about the lower aldehydes and lower ketones. Say one example of lower aldehyde. First member aldehyde, that is nothing but formaldehyde. Say second member aldehyde, that is nothing but acetaldehyde. What is the formula of acetaldehyde, beta? CH3CHO. So these two are nothing but the lower member aldehyde. And what is the lower member ketone? 3 carbon ketone. What is the 3 carbon ketone? That is nothing but the acetone. CH3 bonded to C double bond, O bonded to CH3. So one is formaldehyde, one more is acetaldehyde, one more is acetone. All these three compounds are belongs to example for what? The lower member of aldehydes and ketones. So try to remember this hint. So like this type of lower member of aldehydes, lower member of aldehydes and ketones, they can be soluble in, and also we can say that they can be miscible in, miscible ka meaning ek aur ek se completely mix ho jate beta, they can be soluble or miscible in, simply I want to say that water. So all types of aldehydes and ketones, they cannot be soluble in water. Only lower member of aldehydes and ketones, due to their steric free group, they can be easily miscible in water. I mean soluble in water, nana. But remaining, whatever that may be, lower, higher, whatever that may be, aldehydes and ketones, they must be soluble in organic solvents, highly soluble. But only lower member of aldehydes and ketones, they goes to be miscible in water. Due to reason is because of their forming intermolecular hydrogen bond. So due to formation of intermolecular hydrogen bond between lower member aldehyde and water, lower member ketone and water, due to formation of such intermolecular aldehyde, so due to formation of such intermolecular hydrogen bond between water and lower member of aldehydes and ketones, okay, in between these two types of compound, miscibility, I mean solubility will be, we can see beta. Okay, so now the question is, lower member of aldehydes and ketones are highly miscible in water because of reason why? Reason is, they can easily forms the intermolecular hydrogen bond with water molecule. So how they are going to, okay, now forming the bond? That one I am going to show. So first of all, here I am going to consider lower member of aldehyde or maybe lower member of ketone. Yes, the formula is nothing but, what is the formula of carbonyl group? C double bond O. Yes, I have written there. Yes, here we can write R group. Here also we can write R group. So it is an example of ketone. Instead of R, you can write H. Now it is an example of aldehyde as a Vishnana. Right. So here I am going to consider one water molecule, H bonded to O, again O bonded to H. Next, another mole of carbonyl compound I am going to be consider that C double bond O. Again it connected to 2 side to R group. Okay na? Right beta. As compared to carbon, oxygen contains more electronegativity. And that too, okay, as delocalization of pi bond will be takes place towards the oxygen. So we can say carbon contains partial positive charge and oxygen contains partial negative charge. Here also same thing. Carbon contains partial positive and oxygen contains partial negative. And in water molecule, hydrogen contains partial positive, oxygen contains partial negative. Hydrogen contains partial positive, oxygen contains partial negative. Yes, this is common concept. Now, between a partially positive hydrogen and a partially negative electronegative atom, there will be some electrostatic force, that is nothing but hydrogen bond denoted by dotted lines. Here also same thing beta. Yes, so due to formation of hydrogen bond formation takes place between two molecule, one is aldehyde or maybe ketone with water molecule. So the bond between two molecule, this is intermolecular hydrogen bond between aldehyde and ketone with water. Okay na? So due to formation of such type of intermolecular hydrogen bond, lower member of aldehydes and ketones, they can be soluble in water. स्टोरी क्लियर बेटा? राइट. सो वन मोर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट आई वॉन्ट टू टेल हियर, बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट बेटा, दैट इज नथिंग बट दिल. या सो लोअर मेंबर ऑफ एल्डिहाइड्स एंड कीटोन्स देयर गोज टू बी सॉल्युबल इन वाटर. ओके, बट हियर सॉल्युबिलिटी डिपेंड्स ऑन साइज ऑफ अल्काइल ग्रुप, दैट इज नथिंग बट दिल. साइज ऑफ अल्काइल ग्रुप इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू सॉल्युबिलिटी इन वाटर. फर्स्ट सपोज इन केस ऑफ एल्डिहाइड्स एंड कीटोन्स, एज द साइज ऑफ अल्काइल ग्रुप गोज टू बी इंक्रीज्ड, देयर सॉल्युबिलिटी इन वाटर गोज टू बी डिक्रीज. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट. बिकॉज ऑफ अल्काइल ग्रुप, फर्स्ट सपोज साइज ऑफ अल्काइल ग्रुप इंक्रीजेस, एज द नंबर ऑफ कार्बन, एज द नंबर ऑफ हाइड्रोजन इंक्रीजेस, दैट मीन्स the alkyl group is in the nature is nothing but hydrophobic nature. Which nature beta? Hydrophobic nature. Hydrophobic means water hating species. Okay na beta? Water hating means as the size of alkyl group increases, means its a hydrophobic nature increases. Hydrophobic nature increases means water hating nature will be increased, means they won't soluble in water. I hope you understand. Okay na? So that's why I have told you only lower member of aldehydes and ketones, they can be easily soluble in water. Because of lower member of aldehydes and ketones, they are having smaller size of alkyl group, so easily soluble in water. But in higher member of aldehydes and ketones, there will be large size of alkyl group, they are having more hydrophobic nature, they are having more water hating nature, so they won't soluble in water. I hope you understand. Good. Right beta, so this is the information about the solubility I have told you clearly along with some examples also. Okay, next, last one more physical property is there, that is nothing but the boiling times. Right beta, boiling points. Yeah, so in the boiling point again we have two points, again both the points are very important beta. Yes, in that number one I am going to say that first of all lower member of aldehydes and ketones, after that higher member of aldehydes and ketones, comparison with alcohol and comparison with ether and comparison with hydrocarbon, this comparison is very important beta. Okay, first of all I am going to say the comparison. Yes, this point is very important. Boiling points of aldehydes and ketones are relatively higher than boiling points of ethers and hydrocarbons. A point ke upar focus karna beta. Yes, reason I will tell you, don't worry, but first of all remember. So boiling points of aldehydes and ketones are relatively higher than always ethers and hydrocarbons of comparable molecular masses. A point underline karna padega, comparable molecular masses means their molecular masses are nearly equal. Comparable molecular masses means all four compounds, you suppose they are having nearby same molecular masses. So aldehyde, ketone, ethers and hydrocarbons like methane, ethane, propane, butane, and you suppose all they are having nearby comparable molecular masses, same molecular masses. Even though their molecular masses are same, but generally aapko ek point malum, boiling point is directly proportional to molecular mass. But here I am saying all four compounds they are having same molecular masses, means their boiling point should be same na beta, but here boiling points are different due to reason is, so reason I am going to show you now. So the reason is nothing but aldehydes and ketones, they are having special type of intermolecular forces. intermolecular forces. So now the question is, sir, aldehydes and ketones, they're having which type of intermolecular forces? So the intermolecular forces are nothing but the dipole forces. Okay, beta. So how can you say they are having dipole forces? Aldehydes and ketones, both are nothing but the carbonyl compounds. What is the formula of carbonyl compounds? So this is nothing but bond, C double bond O. Again, bond and bond. This is the formula of carbonyl compound. Aapko maloom very well. Okay, na? Right, as compared to carbon, oxygen contains more electronegativity. So this pi bond will be shifted towards the oxygen. So carbon contains a charge positive and oxygen contains the charge negative. One side positive pole, one more side negative pole. Okay, so this is one molecule. Again we can take another aldehyde, again we can take another ketone, whatever that may be. Every aldehyde, every ketone, nothing much, every carbonyl group, they're having polar nature. So between one mole and between two mole, first mole be polar, second molecule will be polar. So between polar and polar, so we have to say that dipole, okay, attractive forces will be there. So aldehydes and ketones, they are having intermolecular forces due to the reason is polar CO bond. They are having dipole forces, positive pole, negative pole, dipole, again another molecule, positive, negative, dipole. So dipole interactions or strong intermolecular interactions between the aldehydes and between the ketones to break the bonds. Okay, now you required more temperature. Okay, that's why we have to say that they are having what, beta? Higher boiling points. I hope you understand the reason clearly. What about ethers and hydrocarbons? Why they are having lower boiling points? The reason is ethers and hydrocarbons, they do not having DD, means dipole forces. So due to absence of dipole intermolecular forces, they are having low boiling points, and aldehydes and ketones, they are having what, Nana? Higher boiling points. They are having the forces are nothing but the intermolecular forces and dipole forces. Better. Okay, all of you? Right. Next point here, I want to say that. Yeah, beta. So next, another information I want to say about the boiling point, that is nothing but the now comparison with alcohol. Here the comparison with what? Ethers and hydrocarbon. Which contain more? Aldehydes are more. Now comparison with alcohol. Aldehydes and ketones, they are having comparatively and relatively, they are having lower boiling points as compared to the alcohols. The question board paper may be repeated. Why the boiling points of aldehydes and ketones are lower than alcohols? I will tell you the reason. So boiling points of aldehydes and ketones are low, relatively low or lower as compared to the boiling points of what, beta? Alcohols. So alcohols, they are having higher boiling points. Aldehydes and ketones, they are having lower boiling points, even though their molecular masses are comparable molecular masses. Yahan par bhi same condition I am going to be apply that. Comparable molecular masses. So once again, aldehydes, ketones, ethers and hydrocarbon, they are having comparable molecular masses, but their boiling points are different because of depends upon the dipole forces. Next, aldehydes and ketones and alcohol, here also they are having same comparable molecular masses, again their boiling points are different. So here the boiling point depends upon what? Yes, aldehydes and ketones, they do not have the capable of formation of hydrogen bond. So no hydrogen bond formation. Sir, just now you have told you aldehydes and ketones, they are forming hydrogen bond. Aldehydes and ketones, they are forming hydrogen bond, but with water only, not in between them. Two aldehydes do not form the hydrogen bond. Two ketones do not form the hydrogen bond. But aldehydes and ketones, they can form the hydrogen bond with water. But themselves, in between them, they cannot form the hydrogen bond. Okay, na? Except a little bit chances for formaldehyde. Right. Next one is nothing but what, beta? Alcohols. Alcohols, they are having higher boiling points because of what is the formula of alcohol? Is the formula is nothing but ROH. Again, another formula of alcohol, HOR. So this is the formula for alcohol, ROH. So here we can see the formation of which bond? Hydrogen bond. Alcohols, they have the capable of formation of intermolecular hydrogen bond. So to break that intermolecular hydrogen bond in alcohols, you require higher boiling points. But due to lack of hydrogen bond in aldehydes and ketones, okay, to break them, to boil them, you require low boiling point. Okay, now let us. So aldehydes and ketones, they're having relatively lower boiling points than alcohols, even though their molecular masses are comparable. Reason is, alcohols, they have the capable of formation of intermolecular hydrogen bond, but ketones and carbonyl compounds, they do not have the capable of formation of intermolecular hydrogen bonds. Reason clear? Right. Aldehydes and ketones, ethers and hydrocarbon, they are having comparable, but aldehydes are more because of dipole-dipole forces. As compared to aldehydes and ketones, alcohols, they are having higher boiling point. Due to reason is, alcohols in between them, they have the capable of formation of inter-H bond. Such hydrogen bond cannot be formed by carbonyl compounds. This is clear? Right. Next, another point very important for you. Now I want to give the comparison of sir, which contain more boiling point, either aldehyde or ketone. So your answer is nothing but ketone beta. Boiling points of ketones must be little bit higher than the aldehydes. Jada gap nahi aa sakta, okay, na little bit gap nana. So ketones are having slightly higher boiling points than ketones. Ketone ka boiling point slightly jada ho sakta as compared to what aldehydes. The reason I am going to show you. Aldehyde formula, R bonded to C double bond O, again bonded to R. This is the formula of ketone. What is the formula of aldehyde? R bonded to C double bond O bonded to H. This is the formula of aldehyde. So yahan par pi bond shifted towards the oxygen, carbon contain plus, O contain minus. Yes, A bond bhi upar shift karo, carbon contain plus, O contain minus. So this is polar in nature, plus minus polar. Yahan par bhi plus minus means it is also, we can say, polar in nature. So aldehydes and ketones, they are also, we can say, polar in nature due to CO bond. I mean polar CO bond. But in the two, as compared to the aldehyde, ketones are more polar in nature. So reason is why? Carbon contains the charge positive. And positive means it is nothing but carbocation. Stability of carbocation always directly proportional to electron donating group. Here also we can see that electron donating group. So in ketones, how many electron donating groups are there? Due to presence of two electron donating groups around the carbonyl carbon, automatically CO bond that will becomes more polar. As the polar nature increases, boiling point goes to be increased. Because of more polar nature, polarity is directly proportional to boiling point. I hope you understand. Once again, ketones are having slightly higher boiling points as compared to the aldehydes. Because of reason. Of course, aldehydes and ketones both are polar in nature. But as compared to the aldehyde, ketones, they are having somewhat more polar nature. Because of, due to presence of two electron donating nature, CO group, it will becomes more polarized. As the polar nature goes to be increased, boiling point bhi unka kya ho sakta? Automatically that goes to be increased. But here in case of aldehyde, only one electron donating group is there. But yahan par in case of ketone, two electron donating group is there. As compared to aldehyde, ketonic group was highly polarized. Okay, due to this reason only, ketones, they are having slightly higher boiling point as compared to the aldehydes. A 3B, okay, now all three are very, very, very important beta. Okay, now, good. All physical properties are cleared. Now, on the basis of physical properties, one question I want to ask you, okay, now, two questions I want to ask you, the two questions, they are inside the textbook questions, practice them, be right in your FAI notebook, okay, they are very important for final board exam beta. Right. Here, question number one is, arrange the following compounds in their increasing order of boiling point. So I am going to provide some compounds. So all that compound you have to be arranged in their increasing order of boiling points. So boiling point order tum decide karna padega beta. Shall I give you a question? Yes. Question number one. You suppose I am going to write that methoxyethane, nothing much, ethene as it is an example of ether beta. Next one is, I am going to write another example. First, suppose that is nothing but the N propanol, and we can say 1-propanol as you wish. Next, I am going to write another compound. First, suppose that is nothing but the N butane. And one more compound I am going to write, that is nothing but the N butanol, nothing but aldehyde. Okay, na? And sorry, N propanol. Another compound I am going to write, that is nothing but the propanol. And also we can say that 2-propanol as you wish. Propanol. Right. So here I have given around 5 compounds beta. In that all, which contains more boiling point? Ether, hydrocarbon, aldehyde, ketone. Which contain more aldehyde, ketone? But as compared to aldehyde, ketone, which contain more alcohol is more? So sabse jyada alcohol. There is answer N-propanol. So boiling point order is, first answer is what? N-propanol. What is the formula? CH3 bonded to CH2, again bonded to CH2, CH2 bonded to OH. So it is nothing but alcoholic compound. It contains more boiling point because it forms the intermolecular hydrogen bond. Okay, beta? After alcohols, we have to write aldehyde and ketone. But in that aldehyde and ketone, which contain more? Ketone is more. Yes, where is the ketone? Yes, this is propanol. CH3 bonded to C double bond O. After that, what, Nana? CH3. Yes, this is nothing but propanol. And also, we can say that ketone compound. Yeah, after ketone, we have to write what? Aldehyde. Where is the aldehyde? NaL, propanol. So, 3-carbon aldehyde, CH3, CH2, CHO is aldehyde. Right, beta. Next, after aldehyde, what we have to write, beta? Ethers. Yes, after aldehyde, ether. Where is the ether? Methoxyethane. Greater than CH3 bond, O bonded to CH2, CH3. This is nothing but what, beta? Methoxyethane. It is an example of ether. And subse very least boiling point, hydrocarbon, because of their having weak van der Waal forces. So what is hydrocarbon? Butane. Yes, I am going to write that CH3 bonded to CH2, again bonded to CH2, again bonded to CH3. 4-carbon is nothing but butane. Nothing but simply we have to say alkane, and also we can say that hydrocarbon. Okay. N-propyl alcohol, if you want, you can count, its total weight is 60 grams. And here, ketone, given example, propanol, its weight is 58 grams. Again, next one, aldehyde, its weight is also 58 grams. And ether, its weight is 60 grams. And hydrocarbon, its weight is also 58 grams. So almost all 58, 60, means they're having comparable molecular masses. But as compared to hydrocarbon, ether is more. Because of ethers, they are having least boiling point. Due to reason is presence of weak van der Waal forces. As compared to hydrocarbon, ethers are more because of an ether, polar CO bond is there. So little bit they are having polar nature. Next number. And ketones and aldehydes, yes, they are having which type of forces? DD forces, nothing but dipole-dipole interactions. And as compared to aldehyde, ketone is more polar and dipole-dipole interaction. So ketone answer be clear. And finally, alcohol, due to formation of intermolecular hydrogen bond, it contains higher the melting boiling point value. So weak van der Waal, next polar, aldehyde and ketone, they are having polar and also dipole-dipole interaction. Dipole-dipole is main point. And after that, what on alcohol, they are having higher the boiling point due to reason is formation of intermolecular hydrogen bond. In that manner, you have to get the answer. Shall I give you another question? Yes. Second question. A. CH3O, CH3, dimethyl ether. B. CH3, CHO, C. CH3, CH2, OH. Next, D. Another compound I am going to give you, that D is nothing but, first suppose, CH3 bonded to CH2, again bonded to CH3. Come on, say beta. In that 4, which contains more boiling point? So answer is nothing but again same thing. Pahle kya rahe na, alcohol. Where is the alcohol? C greater than alcohol, beta. Yes. Next one is aldehyde and ketone. Which one? Ketone. But here ketone is not there, only aldehyde. Where is aldehyde? B. Yes, after that is B. I have written here. Next one is nothing but water na. After aldehyde we have to be read that. Aldehyde ke baad kya rehna? Ether. Where is the ether? CH3 or CH3. Nothing but A. And next one is hydrocarbon. Where is the hydrocarbon? And D. So this is nothing but the ether and this is nothing but hydrocarbon. So once again, more boiling point. Okay, na compound is alcohol. And one more thing here I want to say that. Yes, yahan par ethyl alcohol contain 46 grams. And ether also contain 46 grams. And aldehyde and yahan par hydrocarbon, both they are having 44 grams. Means again their boiling points are comparable. I mean their molecular masses are comparable, but they are having different in boiling point. So sabse more which contain more alcohol because of it forms the hydrogen bond. And after that what na aldehyde because of they are having dipole-dipole forces. And after that what ether, little bit they are having polar interaction. And hydrocarbon, very weak van der Waals forces. Like that you have to give the order of boiling points of the comparable molecular masses compounds. One is, first of all we have to write the alcohol, after that alcohol we have to write the ketone, after that ketone aldehyde, after that ether, after that hydrocarbon. So higher molecular masses, alcohol, after that ketone, after that aldehyde, next one is nothing but what beta? Ether, and very least boiling point is hydrocarbon because of they are having weak van der Waals forces. Okay beta, yes, both the questions are very very important. Story about the physical properties of aldehydes and ketones was over, and in tomorrow's class I am going to start about the chemical properties of aldehydes and ketones. Very very important topic. Okay, so kal ki class mein milenge beta, take care.